FingerprintJS Pro is a service that uses browser fingerprinting and other techniques to accurately identify visitors to your website. It can be used to protect your website from fraud, detect account sharing, prevent multiple signups, and many other things. Imagine that you run an online course platform that offers free 14-day trials. You want to prevent these trial users from registering several accounts with multiple emails and extending their trials indefinitely. Let's see how FingerprintJS can help you prevent that. To begin, I have started a new FingerprintJS subscription. If you don't have one, just go to fingerprintjs.com and start a free trial. It's very easy to do and will only take a couple of minutes. Now I need to install the code of the JavaScript agent on my website. So I'm going to copy the snippet and paste it in the template for my signup page. My example website is a Node.js app with handlebars templates, but this will work fine with any technology you're using in your project. My token is already in the snippet, and I have a console log statement here, so let's see if it's working. Let's open the developer console and reload the page. Here's a visitor ID returned by the FingerprintJS API. Let's use it to prevent additional signups. We'll start with sending the visitor ID to our server, along with the email. So, we'll create a hidden form field and set visitor ID as its value. That's it for the front end. Now let's go to the server. Here, we will receive the visitor ID, so let's store it in our database. We'll need to add a column, so let's create a migration. Now let's run it. We can see our new column appear in our database. Now we can store the visitor ID, so let's modify our insert statement. Finally, we need to check if the visitor ID is already in our system. And if it is, return an error. That's it. Now, let's save this and go back to our application. Let's reload the page and test it. I'm going to sign up for the first time, and then try it once again in the incognito mode. Looks like it's working as expected. You can find all the code from this example in our GitHub repository. Thanks for watching.